Please stand.
Have turned to me and have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am alone and poor. See my loneliness and suffering, and take away all my sins, my God.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, this is the fast that I wish, releasing those bound unjustly, untying the thongs of the yoke, setting free the oppressed, breaking every yoke, sharing your bread with the hungry, sheltering the oppressed and the homeless, clothing the naked when you see them and not turning your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. If you remove from your midst oppression, false accusation, and malicious speech, if you bestow your bread on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then light shall rise for you in darkness, and the gloom shall become for you like midday. Then the Lord will guide you always and give you plenty, even on the parched land. For he will renew your strength, and you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring whose water never fails.
The word of the Lord.
Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him. He will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger and you welcomed me. Naked and you clothed me. Ill and you cared for me. In prison and you visited me." Then the righteous will answer him and say, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?" And the king will say to them in reply, "Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me." Then he will say to those on his left, "Depart from me, you accursed. Enter the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. A stranger and you gave me no welcome. Naked and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison and you did not care for me." Then they will answer and say, "Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?" He will answer them, "Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me." And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Catholic sisters have been embraced by the Macon community in an ecumenical and interfaith way since the 1800s, when the Sisters of Mercy began what would become St. Joseph's School, but in reality, it was the beginning of the public school system here in Macon. Later, with Mount DeSales, the Sisters of Mercy, through their school system, were embraced by all of Macon, as were St. Peter Claver's Sisters of the Most Blessed Sacrament, and today, the Daughters of Charity, who do such wonderful ministries here in Macon, from St. Peter Claver School to ministry to our Catholic Hispanic population, to the Family Advancement Ministry, to our pro-life ministry, the Colby Center, and finally to DePaul USA's Daybreak ministry for the homeless. In fact, this year has been designated by Pope Francis as the year of religious life. And I am glad that we can honor not only Sister Elizabeth, but all the sisters who have ministered in a powerful way and have had an awesome impact on all of Macon, not just the Catholics that are here, but all of Macon. And we need more sisters. And I hope that you are praying for more vocations to the religious life so that the legacy of the ministry of Catholic sisters can continue here in Macon and throughout the world. In honoring our daughter of charity, Sister Elizabeth, we honor all Catholic sisters and the ministries they have led that have brought the saving ministry of Jesus Christ to so many people, not just Catholics, but to all people. For us as Catholics, faith and good works are necessary for our own personal salvation, because this translates into a faith that reaches out beyond the confines of fierce individualism or the confines of the church or a particular church building. It reaches out to all who are in need of salvation, not only in the world to come, but also in this world during our earthly pilgrimage. As a daughter of charity, Sister Elizabeth personifies what it means to be a Catholic and to integrate faith and good works into her life, not just for her own benefit, but for the benefit of others, especially the poor. The city of Macon read in the Macon Telegraph on Holy Thursday, which is the Thursday before Easter Sunday, that Sister Elizabeth was moving to Little Rock to establish the same kind of wonderful and loving ministry as Daybreak does here. 2 years prior to that, Sister Elizabeth was named by the Macon Telegraph as Person of the Year. But the headline on Holy Thursday's Macon Telegraph stated the following: Beloved nun to leave Macon. And then Scotty Nelson is quoted as saying, Sister Elizabeth has brought love and nurturing and kindness and gentleness and a fierce spirit about her that brings all of us together and brings this place together in which we call Daybreak. And a video at the Macon Telegraph's website of her own announcement to the homeless, one can hear the homeless shouting out to Sister Elizabeth, No, don't go. We love you. Stay. And I suspect that many of us this afternoon want to say the same thing to Sister Elizabeth. Stay, sister. We don't want to give you a send-off. Stay. That's an order. Catholic sisters and the daughters of charity in particular personify the example of the sheep in the gospel reading, the ones who are destined for salvation. They personify seeing Jesus in the needy and attending to his needs, whether he be homeless, a stranger from another land, hungry, thirsty, in prison, or sick. Now, I have to say to you, as a priest, but more so as a Catholic, I'm proud to see a Catholic sister embraced so lovingly here in Macon, not only by the Catholics, but all religions and those of no religions. In fact, those of no religions are called nuns. Did you know that? N-O-N-E-S, rather than N-U-S. But she's been embraced by everyone, atheists and agnostics. So in the person of a Catholic sister, Jesus Christ is universally accepted in the most implicit way possible. And when I say Jesus, I mean our risen Lord, who remains with us today in the Holy Spirit and through the ministries of the church, like what DePaul USA does here in Macon through Daybreak, a truly interfaith outreach to the homeless. So tonight we give thanks to God through his Son Jesus for the ministries he has given to the church to help the poor and those who live on the margins of society, the periphery, as Pope Francis would describe it. This is a joyful celebration, although it is tinged with a bit of grief. This seems to be a little bit like a funeral, doesn't it? But the deceased, Sister Elizabeth, is alive. thanks be to God. Or is it a resurrection appearance after her death, similar to the Lord's resurrection? I don't know. But it appears that I'm not the only one who feels like Sister Elizabeth's departure to Little Rock is like a death for Macon. Even the rabbi in town, Rabbi Larry Schlesinger of Temple Beth Israel, wanted to canonize Sister Elizabeth as a Catholic saint when he spoke at the dedication of Daybreak's newest venture, Where? And he asked if a Jewish rabbi could canonize a Catholic sister, and I thought to myself, be my guest. But we have a higher authority with us tonight, Bishop Boland, so the good rabbi, if he appears, can ask the bishop if it would be kosher for him to canonize Sister Elizabeth. But if this were a funeral mass for Sister Elizabeth, which to some of us it seems like it is, we would be praying for her immortal soul to speedily exit purgatory. Yet she has chosen to leave Macon, which is heaven, and go to Little Rock, Arkansas, which in reality is purgatory. It is, really. You're leaving heaven for purgatory, Sister Elizabeth. Maybe we do need to pray for your immortal soul at this Mass after all. As Sister Elizabeth and many of my parishioners know of me, I don't like to canonize Catholics as saints during their funeral Mass. The Church prefers that we simply commend them to God's mercy and allow Him to do the canonizing on His own. But this isn't a funeral Mass, nor is it the canonization ceremony. Only the Pope can canonize. But we do thank you, Sister, for your years of service here in Macon, for taking the directorship of Family Advancement Ministry so many years ago, and then later for helping to found Daybreak and our pro-life ministry, the Colby Center. But most of all, we thank you not just for what you do, but for who you are. A woman created in the image and likeness of God, who by God's grace has found her identity as a Christian in the Catholic Church and as a daughter of charity. Helping the poor and those who cannot defend or provide for themselves, the most innocent among us, the unborn, as well as guarding life after birth until natural death, is part of the Church's seamless garment that we call being pro-life. We thank you for that witness. We thank you for your loving witness to this reality of the Church's life and mission here in Macon, and we will all miss you. Sister Elizabeth wanted her farewell to be within the context of a Catholic Mass, what we are celebrating this evening. Because of who she is and what she does flows from her Catholicism and from being a daughter of charity. As we continue this Holy Mass and enter into the one sacrifice of Jesus on the cross, who suffered and died for our salvation, and as we worthily receive his body and blood, may we all know that we are being strengthened by the very grace of God, so that when we are dismissed from this Mass, we will all go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
We have all gathered here, dear brothers and sisters, to celebrate the year of religious life, a and to honor the Daughters of Charity and Sister Elizabeth. Let us pray for their needs and for the needs of everyone in the world.
For all men and women religious who have vowed themselves to God, that with his help they may faithfully keep their resolve, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church of God, that by his outpower of grace, God may protect and defend Pope Francis, all bishops, priests, and deacons of the Church in their ministries, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace among nations, that delivered from all turmoil, they may serve God in freedom of heart as they enact laws of peace and justice, protecting humanity from conception until natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the elderly and all who suffer from isolation, injury or sickness, poverty and homelessness, that they may be strengthened by our love of them as brothers and sisters, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Daughters of Charity and Sister Elizabeth as she departs Macon, may their ministries continue to assist all who are in need, and may they find blessings from God in all they do. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, in particular all deceased religious sisters who have served in Macon, and for all who grieve them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of this Mass for Sister Elizabeth, and for those who assist in Christian outreach, and for ourselves gathered here, that as God's will continue to sustain us with the things of this life, that we may know how to use them in such a way that we may hold even now to the things that endure forever. Let us pray in silence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, let us now pray our diocesan prayer for vocations.
O God,
hear our prayer, and let our cry come unto you. Bless our diocese of Savannah with many vocations to the priesthood and the active religious life.
Give the men and women you call a life of understanding your gift and the love of all of all.
May your mercy, we beseech you, O Lord, be with your people who call upon you, so that what they seek at your prompting they may obtain by your ready generosity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctify, we pray, O Lord, through these holy things we offer you, the servants you have gathered in your name, so that faithfully fulfilling their vows to you, they may serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Take this, all of you, and drink from it,
For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory John, our Bishop, Kevin, our celebrating Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Say,
our Father, who art in
we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
My dear friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
And will be yours, and for Lord.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that your servants, gathered in your love and partaking of the one bread, may be of one heart in prompting each other in the pursuit of charity and good works, so that through a holy way of life, they may always and everywhere be true witnesses to Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Good evening. As Father had said in his homily, it was a great desire of mine that as I began to talk to people about leaving and different groups like the St. Vincent de Paul Society and folks at Daybreak and folks in MG Alert, our anti-trafficking group, and different said, well, how are we going to say goodbye? And I realized it could get really out of hand if all those groups wanted to say goodbye in their own way. And I realized this was a moment for me to be able to say goodbye my way, and to say that the reason I came to Macon was because my community and my God sent me here. And when we talk about interfaith work, and we talk about bringing churches and faiths and those of no faith and those of partial faith and those who aren't sure of their faith together, that no one of us ever water down who we are, but that we bring the joy of who we are and what motivates us and what inspires us and what fills our hearts, that we bring it to the full. Clearly, this was no watered down mass. And that was important to me. It's important to me to share with you the fullness of the faith that I have in the God that I follow, and to thank him for sending me here. St. Lawrence, some of you don't know about St. Lawrence, was challenged, I think it was by a king, you could read the story, Google St. Lawrence. He was asked to bring the treasures of the church, you know, because everyone thinks the church is really rich, and to bring all the treasures of the church to the king. And what St. Lawrence did was he brought to the church all those who were poor and homeless, all those who were struggling and vulnerable, and said, these people, these are the treasures of the church. So tonight, I have brought my treasure to the church, and that's each of you. And I've brought it to the altar of the God that I worship to give him thanks that our paths have crossed, that he chose this time and this place for me to grow up as a daughter of charity. 10 years ago, I was only 9 years a daughter of charity. Now I'm 19. Went from being a middle schooler to a graduate. And I could only do that because of the gift of each of you. None of us do any of this ourselves. We can joke about canonizations and all that. None of us do any of this by ourselves. We all do it in community and in together. We do it as one family before whatever God it is that we worship, but that we do it in a way that says to each member of that community, without you, the community would be lacking. Without you, the community would be less. Without each one of us, the work can't get done. So, to be thankful to God is the first place for me. It's to bring each of you the gems of this experience that I've had in Macon. To bring each of you to God and thank him with the fullest of hearts that I can. I've said to my friend June Bryant, I spend a lot of time in Little Rock saying, where is my June Bryant in Little Rock? Where is my Kay Gerhardt? Where are my new pastors? Where are the new, all of the people that I've met here, where are they in Little Rock? And they're there. I know God will gift me there as much as here. And I can only hope that I can be of service there as much as I have tried to be here. But I also need to give thanks to, obviously, each of you, to each of the groups that have come together to serve those who are vulnerable, to serve those who live in poverty, to thank all those who let their vulnerabilities be known and have allowed me and those who have helped me and have helped each of us to be better people. Some of us are housed now that weren't before. Some of us are working now that weren't before. Some of us are more aware of the struggles that others had than we weren't before. All of that is God's gift. I want to thank everyone on the altar here and each person who's helped with this Mass to make it a joyful celebration. Some of you who aren't Catholic might not get all of it, you know, the smells, the bells, the whistles, but it means an enormous amount to me. And so I'm grateful, and especially grateful to our bishop who came and to the priests and deacons and servers. And I'd like to say to each of the young people here, this is an amazing church that we belong to. And as you grow up into it, you'll see that we might look old and seem old, but we're pretty powerful folks. And we're so grateful that each of you are here helping us to worship and helping us to thank our God for all that he gives us. But lastly, I would like to especially thank my sisters. I can't do anything without them. They are the ones I go home to every night. And they are the ones who have to put up with me every night. They are the ones who have to hear the crazy stories of what happened during the day. They're the ones who help put me in my place when I need to be put there. They're the ones who help to challenge me when I get slacking. They're the ones who can help push me out the door. They're the ones who remind me of how I have to take care of myself when I'm sick. They are the greatest gift that God has given me. My community and my sisters have helped me to find my fullest self, and I am so grateful to each of you and grateful that you've been here and that you support me, as I say, even in the times when it's difficult to be supportive. So I go to Little Rock with each of you in my heart, praying to God that I find replications of each of you there, hoping that Little Rock will be an experience much like Macon, and remembering always that Macon is the mother church, that Macon is, and Daybreak and DePaul USA and all of our groups are the beginnings, and I bring all of that with me. I just want to thank each of you and know that you will be in my constant prayers. I just want to say one last thing to Father McDonald especially. He ordered me to stay. No offense, Father, but I don't take orders from you. But I know that we both take orders from the one who is so much greater than us. And both he and I and all those of us who have fulfilled our vocations, and each of us has a vocation, we believe that we are following the orders of our God. And it is God who sends me forth as a daughter of charity, as a Catholic woman, as a woman open to serving those who are vulnerable, and being able to serve in my own vulnerability. So, with all of that, we're gonna go have cupcakes. Because this is also a celebration of all that we have been together. And cupcakes just happen to be one of my favorite things, and it's not often you get to just say, we're gonna have cupcakes today. So, I invite you all for cupcakes and iced coffee, or whatever else they decided to have, because they think not everyone's gonna want that. There are three ways that you can get to the cupcakes. You can either go out the side door and down a flight of stairs off to the left. You can go out the back doors or the front doors, whatever you decide. You can go out that way and down the steps, and there's an entrance down there. Or if you want to wait a little while and possibly miss a cupcake, or if you need to, there is an elevator in the back right behind us. So there are three ways to get there. I hope that you will all join us there. And again, thank you to each and every one of you, and thank you to all of you who have helped us worship here today. Thank you so very much.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the God of all consolation order your days in his peace and grant you the gifts of his blessing.
Amen.
May he free you always from every distress and confirm your hearts in his love.
Amen.
So that on this life's journey you may be effective in good works, rich in the gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may come happily to eternal life.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.